Dr. Jaitz, welcome to the first session of this term. And I would want us to start looking at an application software we call Excel. Look at Excel, introduction to Excel. So when we talk of Excel, it's one of the suites of programs contained in what we call Microsoft Office. We have what we call Microsoft Office. Inside Microsoft Office, we have Microsoft Word, we have Microsoft Excel, we have MS PowerPoint, also have MS Publisher, MS Access. So, etc. There are others, of course, but these are the most common types of software that we use on a computer. Then all these are loaded in what we call Microsoft Office. And Microsoft Office can be Office 2010, Office 2013, Office 2016. I know Office 2019 is out, but I haven't used it. I will be experimenting with you using Office 2016. And all the programs, Microsoft Office is known as an integrated software. It is integrated software because it has got more than one application in it. And some of the applications that are found in MS Office are the one listed here. Among the Office applications, we will start with the Microsoft Excel this term. I introduced to you Microsoft Word in term one. So, opening Microsoft Office is easy. The same way you open Microsoft Word is the same way we are going to open Microsoft Excel. Then I'll browse for it. There it is. I'll click. There it is. Just loaded. So that is a welcome template for Microsoft Excel. Okay. Looking from here up to there, the top part here, they are similar in all Office application. You would have seen these in Microsoft Word. They are just similar to the ones we are going to encounter in Microsoft Excel. To start with, the top part there, there is File, Home, Insert, Tab Layout, Formula, Data, Review, and View. These are known as tabs. So in case they ask us to count the number of tabs, we'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this Office document has got 8 tabs. Now under each tab, so as it is, Home tab is selected. And what you're able to see under the ribbon here are the tools for Home tabs. There is here where we change the font name, the font size. But if I change and I go to Insert tab, the tools are going to change. The tools are going to change. We've got other tools under the Insert tab. Equally, when I go on Page Layout, the tools are going to change. So, this part where we see tools under any tab, we call it a ribbon. So to illustrate a ribbon properly, let me open Microsoft Word so that I can capture the ribbon. Where is Word? Word, there is Microsoft Word. Wage is loading. There it is. Can change the page layout for wage to landscape. There. I want to insert under the insert tab. I want to insert a ribbon so that you see the beginning and the end of the ribbon for Excel. So starting from here all the way up to the end there. So what is going to display here, this is exactly what we call a ribbon. So every time I'm mentioning a ribbon during the course of this lesson, this should be popping up in your mind as a ribbon. So the ribbon as the tabs together with the tools. I'm sure you have seen that. So from here to there, that's what we call a ribbon. And on top there, we've got what we call the tabs. Now, first things in Excel. In Microsoft Word, as you saw from this document, before I inserted a ribbon, it has got one white blank working space. That is Microsoft Word. But for Excel, it has a lot of boxes. As you can see, all these boxes. So, those small boxes that we are able to see in Excel as their special names. And the name of a box in Excel is known as a cell. A cell is a single box in Excel. Excel is made of a lot of boxes. And each one of those boxes refers us to a cell. So there is this cell, there is that cell, all these cells put together. They form what we call Excel worksheet. So what is a cell? When we say a cell, we'd say a cell is a basic building block of Excel worksheet. So it's simply the basic building block of an Excel worksheet. Excel is made up of so very many boxes. So when I choose the first cell there, we are going to see up there, which is called a name box. A name box is a box that displays the address of a cell. We do this. So we introduced what a cell is. Now, on top of that, we are going to add what we call name box. This is very important because it gives the address of the cell you are working with. Every time we select a cell, that cell name is going to be displayed in a name box. And apart from the name box, for starting up, we need to understand this big box there. This is what we call the formula bar. The formula bar is going to be used to display formulas in Excel. So that is for starting Excel. Now, basically, what is Excel? When we say Excel, it belongs to a category of application we call spreadsheets. Spreadsheet. If they ask you to give an example of a spreadsheet, you'd say Excel. This is one application you can use for analyzing data and calculating numbers using formulas. So with a spreadsheet, you can analyze data,
analyze the data, you can sort the data, you can do what we call a budget with this. Of course, there are other things that you can use with the Excel. Then Excel just uses the three types of characters. The three types of characters we are going to use in Excel. One, we've got what we call numbers. Two, we've got what we call formulas. Three, we've got what we call labels. These three are Excel data types. The types of data we can use in Excel. They are Excel data types. So there is nothing else you can enter into Excel apart from these three things. And analyzing, sorting, budgeting are some of the things you can do with Excel. And Excel belongs to a category we call the spreadsheet. Let's look at the addresses. So when I come to the first address, this cell is on top, there is A, on the left side there is 1. The intersection is the name of that cell. So this is cell A1. As you can see in the name box, cell A1. When I come to this cell, the intersection is between B and 1. And hence, where it's saying name box, it will be B1. If I select any other cell inside there, it's M, and on the left side it's 7. As you can see in the name box, it's M7. So all the cells in Excel can be named in this fashion. Each cell has the address. And normally in Excel, they will ask you to enter a formula in a specified address. If you enter it in a wrong cell, they'll give you a 0. So ensure that you understand how to give a name to a cell. And we give a name to a cell based on the alphabetical number at the top and the numerical number on the left. Where they intersect, that is the name of that cell. So there are a lot of cells. I can go using the scroll bar, I can go down, can be clicking. There are just so many cells. We'll look at this next time, but what is important is for you to know that there are thousands and thousands of cells. If I come to the name box there, I can type X64,000. That is the name of a cell. When I press the enter key, it will take me to that cell. That is cell XX64,000. That is simply to show you that there are thousands of cells in Excel. So let me go to cell A1. That is the first cell. I just typed there A1 and I'm back at cell A1. So basically, this is what you'll be following every time you want to give a name of a cell. And if I ask you to identify the cell name, just look at the name box and the name of the cell is going to be indicated. To move a little bit further, I want to select this cell. And when I click in this cell, look at the lines surrounding the cell. They are thicker than the rest of the cells. So every time you select, that box becomes highlighted. So when you select a cell, it becomes highlighted. So an highlighted cell is a selected cell. A cell which is selected or highlighted is active. Why is it active? Because anytime you want to type anything from the keyboard, the data you are typing will go to the active cell. Any cell you select becomes active. And that is the cell which will be ready to receive the data. That's why we say it's in an active cell. An active cell is the one that will be ready to receive the data from input. So, looking at this screen, if I click in this cell and attempt to type something, let me type something, MNBV. If I type, it will go to the cell which is selected. If I attempt to select a different cell and I type something, the data that I'm going to type will go to that selected cell. So, why is data going there? Because it's the cell that is active. So, look at the bottom there. Here it is saying ready. Ready to receive the input. No sooner I type something, it will change to enter, which simply means that now this cell is ready to receive input from the keyboard. So, this is simply the beginning of a lot of things we're going to do in Excel. And I want you to practice naming the cell. Also, you need to understand when we use, the reason why we use Excel. The few examples I gave you is that we use Excel for preparing the budget, for sorting the data, and the third one that you see on this, inside the video we are watching. What else are we supposed to remember from Excel? We need to remember the data types. The data types I mentioned that we use the labels. When we talk about labels, labels are alphabetical characters. The A, B, C, D, etc. They are labels. Then the numbers are numerical characters. Then the formulas, we look at the formulas, and most of the time we spend doing will be based on a formula in dealing with the Excel. So those are the few things that you need to remember as at now. And hopefully we have learned a few things from the introduction to Excel. And I'll see you in the next lesson as we build up on the introduction to Excel. Thank you very much and see you next time.